My experience in Nam, it was, it could be said at one time it was like a one big hoo house or short time bars, and it was, for me anyway, I looked at it as very degrading to the Vietnamese women, but it was a very, very big industry there. Saigon, everybody knows about Trudeau Street, you get your tea, but, and sexual fave is now. Is the military controlling that, or the culture over there different, so that, or can you still get satisfied wherever an army goes? It seems like there are places for, established for it. Is that still the same, or is it changed?
I think a lot has changed because we're so isolated. We're in our little fobs. We hardly interact with the society. We can't put our weapon up and go down to the cafe. There's the fraternization between Americans and Iraqis is very much restricted. There might be laborers that come onto our camp or doing different jobs, but very rarely are there any females doing those jobs. I've never seen one actually doing those jobs. So when we're actually out on patrol, we got our gear on, we got our game faces on, and there's very little time to take advantage of those situations. It does happen. And there's even male prostitution that happens, but I think it's a lot more rare. But there are situations where we were deployed in other places that the opportunity was more available, like Kosovo, and there's other areas in the world that we are deployed to that's definitely a problem.
Yeah. I think that's why a lot of male soldiers got attracted and went toward the female soldiers, because there were no females out in the towns who would touch us or who would risk the ostracization of their society, because the Iraqi society, as I understand, is a lot different from Vietnamese society. So,
the amount of Amerasians, I don't know what the number is, but that was a big problem after the war. Amerasians, peoples in Vietnam were ostracized because they, obviously, and we brought a lot over here too. But,